Hello beautiful people and welcome back to yet another video. If this is your first time stopping here, thank you so much. And if you are indeed a returning subscriber or you are a returning viewer but you're not here subscribed, welcome, welcome all the same. I am delighted to have you guys back on my channel. And if this is your first time, my name is Onyeka and I'm a Nigerian Canadian YouTuber. I make videos all things lifestyle, immigration, nursing, career stuff. Please be sure to check out my previous content as I'm sure that there is definitely something there for you to watch and you might just decide to stick around because I know you're gonna fall in love with me, okay? If you do decide to stick around, please be sure to subscribe. I highly encourage you to stick around because this is the right place to be, okay? So please subscribe to my channel, click on that button down below, and when you do subscribe, please do not forget to turn on that little notification button so that you can get notified whenever I post a video and you will not miss any of my content at all. Okay guys, so this is the year 2024 and I don't need to say how the inflation or the high cost of living has been affecting everybody. Like, this is because I'm Nigerian, I know how crazy things are in Nigeria right now, and this is not just in Nigeria, and I feel like it's a global thing. Wherever you're located, just let me know how things are. Like, when I was starting this video, I was going to make it scripted, like just put a script and talk about like how much salary is going to be enough to be able to live in Canada in the year 2024. I was going to make it like a scripted video, but right now I'm just going to wing it, like have like an open conversation, look at my script and do whatever I need to do and just make this video engaging, okay? And I will also love to hear from you guys in the comment section. So if this is something you're interested in, if you really want to know how much salary is enough to be able to live as a single person versus a family in Canada in 2024, keep watching and don't go anywhere. Can I dance for you? So guys, in the year 2024, a lot of countries are going into recession. I think the latest one is like the UK right now. And these are trying times, guys. Like, I don't even need to tell you, you already know. And with regards to Canada, determining how much salary will be enough for you or your family to live comfortably in Canada depends on so many factors. It could be your location, your lifestyle choices, your family, and your personal preferences, okay? So living in Canada, it sort of like offers you a high standard of living, if you call it that, quality education, free healthcare, as they say, with crazy long wait times. Having like diverse cultural experiences. However, these costs, like I mentioned earlier, it varies across people, location, and countries. So in Canada, there are like some major metropolitan cities, and some of them include, you have Vancouver, you have Toronto, you have Montreal, and there are a few others, but these are like the most popular ones. And it's also nice to live in these places, but deciding to live in these places comes at a huge cost. If you're Nigerian, you probably understand, like, it's just like deciding to live in Lagos or Abuja. So you can only imagine. So for me, while I was single, right now I'm married, when I was single, the amount of money I used to spend on myself monthly versus now, I miss the single days. So when I first came to Canada, I can beat my chest and tell you my monthly expenses, because I was living in a shared house, was about somewhere from 1,000 to 1,500 monthly, if not less. Because when I first came, I was a student, I lived in Canada. So maybe this might give you an insight as to how that may apply to you. But this was in 2018. My rent was $575. I was living in a 4-bedroom apartment. It was $575, all inclusive. And then my groceries a month would probably be around maybe $200 to $300, depending on what I'm consuming. And my personal miscellaneous spending would be around maybe $200, depending. So like I said, it was somewhere between $1,000 to $1,500. And that was as of 2018, 2019. Afterwards, I had to do my practicum. And I did my practicum in Vancouver, which is a major metropolitan city. And that in itself increased my cost of living significantly because rent was way more expensive and I wasn't living in a shared house. I was living in a single place, so it was way more expensive My rent at that time for a very small one bedroom apartment was approximately like 1200 as of 2019. I would say cost of living for me went up to about 1800 per month for my rent and for like my spending, my groceries, my everything. So you can see like as I'm progressing, it's getting more. And then after my practical, I worked for like a year and stuff like that. And then I came back to London for my nursing school. And again, I was living in a shared apartment. It was a shared two-bedroom basement. And this was the year 2020. I was paying $600 for a room. It wasn't all-inclusive. I had to also pay my internet. And then my cost of living came down because I moved to a smaller city. So again, my monthly expenses was between like 1,000 to 1,500. So you see the difference between living in a smaller city versus living in a major city. Not everybody has to live in a big city, okay? And then afterwards, I moved to a separate one-bedroom apartment. And because it was a one-bedroom apartment, I needed my own independence. That went up to, like, my monthly expenses went up to approximately $2,000. But it was more, but still within the same city. So I'm giving you these prices as a single person, okay? But if you're married, if you have like kids or a family of four, this is gonna like double depending on your lifestyle. I remember when I was in school, I used to be like, oh, after school I'll move to Toronto, I want to be there, that's a place to be, oh, that's where I want to be, stuff like that. And then I was not looking at the price for rent after school. I was like, ah, I was seeing like a nice one bedroom apartment for like, because I wanted to be stay like somewhere around Mississauga, the GTA area. I was shopping and I saw like a one bedroom apartment was going for about 2,000 to 2,500 for like a nice one bedroom, like, you know, those newly constructed apartments. Yeah, it was going for about 2,000 to 2,500 as of 2021. Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, you can see I'm living in London. So I just told myself, like, what are your priorities? Like, living in the GTA area, are you going to be able to save enough money in order to buy a house in the future versus living here? And are you, again, the question was, where do you want to live? Where are you able to afford a house? Realistically, I was not going to be able to afford a house in the GTA area. It was more, or whatever I was going to be able to afford at that time was not going to be within my standard or my taste or what I wanted. So it was just easier for me to stay back here, okay? Yeah, so that's what I did and that worked for me. With owning a house, obviously, comes with its own costs, and my monthly cost of living has tripled significantly. So, but that's not for this video. It's for another video. Someone actually asked me, what is a good salary for a single person in Canada? I would say, it depends. Are you into luxury things? Are you into the fine things of life, the finer things? If that's what you're into, then I would say you need to be taking home nothing less than, I was going to say $4,000, but that is not even enough, because let's say you're living in the GTA and you're paying like $2,000 for rent or $2,500. $1,500 is not going to cut it. So I feel like if you want to live the luxurious life, okay, your take-home salary should be approximately $6,000 as a single person after tax. But that's me pushing it. If you want to buy all the designers, you know, the Dior, the Gucci, $6,000. Let's say you pay your rent $2,500, you pay your car note $500, you pay your insurance another maybe $200. That leaves you with like less than half of your salary to enjoy, okay? But if you're like a humble person, if you're a humble spender like me, a reasonable amount for you to take home monthly will be about $4,000. And you taking home $4,000 after tax, meaning it means that your gross salary would be, wait, let me Google it, like your gross monthly income needs to be about $6,000, and then when you deduct all your taxes, your benefits, your take home will now be like $4,000. So $6,000 monthly times 12, so 6 times 10 is 60, plus 12, so about 72k as a single person. But you find out a lot of people with kids are not even earning as much, so you have to significantly reduce your lifestyle. So for a couple, let's say you're living like a two-bedroom apartment in London, a two-bedroom apartment right now should be approximately $2,000, because things are really skyrocketing, should be approximately $2,000. And then in the GTA area, it should be about 3,000 to 3,500. Imagine paying for that for rent alone, and then with your other monthly expenses, you need to be taking home approximately about 5,500 monthly. Take home. All of these are just my opinion, so feel free to let me know what you guys think in the comment section. I mean, I could be wrong, like I said, this applies differently to people, okay? So if you're taking home $3,500 monthly as a couple, again, it depends on where you're living. If you're living somewhere that the rent is about $1,500 for a two-bedroom, you have at least $2,000 for your extra expenses. And when I say extra expenses, there's your utilities, your internet, your gas, your water. There's your transportation. Do you have a car? Are you taking the bus? You have to pay for the car. You have to pay for your insurance. And then there's your groceries. There's also your healthcare. If you're not a permanent resident yet, you have to pay like for your health insurance. And there's also like miscellaneous spendings. You have to also buy things for yourself once in a while. And then for a family of four, obviously you cannot stay in a one bedroom. It is gonna be a crazy living situation. For a family of four, you minimum, I think you need at least two bedroom apartments to live. And for a decent sized two bedroom apartment in Toronto, I'm just gonna assume it's $3,000. So $3,000 for your rent, and for your other bills, you have to account for like an additional $1,500. But again, you have kids, they're gonna be eating and wearing diapers. So let's add an additional $2,000. And let's say your kids are no longer babies or toddlers, they're in school. Sometimes they need to play, they need to do like soccer practice, basketball practice, they need to do games, they need to do swimming, stuff like that. They have memberships that they pay, and this can come for like $200, $300 monthly per child. There's also daycare. So in my opinion, call me crazy, but for a family of four, you need to have at least $6,000 coming in monthly. You know the amount I said, that $6,000, if you want to be born as a single person, that's how much I feel like would be okay for a family of four that are living within their means. It's really important for families to have multiple sources of income, like dual income, like both the mother and the father, they are working. But if it's not possible, I don't know how you're gonna do it. But a household running on a single income is gonna be really tough on whoever is working. It's gonna be really tough because everything you're just earning is just going into your bills up and down. So guys, let's have an open conversation in the comment section. Let me know what it was like for you, how much you were paying when you first moved to Canada. Like, it could be 10 years ago, 5 years ago, depending, I don't know. Just let me know in the comment section versus how much you're paying now. Like, what's the percentage increase in your cost of living before versus now? Just let me know in the comment section and we can have a conversation. If you also have more questions, please leave it in the comment section. This video, I just wanted it to be like something, I don't know, not too structured, but just let it flow, because I feel like these are my best performing videos when it's just free flowing. I remember when I first came to London, I used to say London was cheap. Guys, London is not cheap, you know, because during the pandemic, a lot of people moved away from the GTA area. And then they moved back here and everything became really expensive. So it's still expensive. It's not cheap again. Okay, guys. I don't want to make this video too long. It tops 10 minutes. And where would you advise families to live? Like, families that are having kids, would you advise them to live in the GTA area or like in the suburbs? Okay. If you enjoyed this video, smash the like button, subscribe to my channel, share this video. Okay. I'll see you guys in my next video. Take care and bye.